Students, our today's topic is civil disobedience movement. Civil disobedience movement, you have done till 11 demands of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji gave an ultimatum to Lord Irwin that his demands must be fulfilled by 11th March. Irwin declared all the demands unrealistic, useless. So that's why Gandhiji had to launch civil disobedience movement on 12th March. 12th March 1930, he had to launch civil disobedience movement. Is it clear? Date aapko learn rehni chahiye, 11th March tak ultimatum, and then on 12th March 1930, Gandhiji started civil disobedience movement. When he started, write note on civil disobedience movement, Ajay. So you will write this, ke this movement was started on 12th March 1930. And the meaning of this movement, in this movement, Gandhiji asked Indians to disobey British rule. क्या कहा इंडियंस को डिसओबे एज इन नॉन कोऑपरेशन मूवमेंट गांधी जी आस्क्ड इंडियंस नॉट टू कोऑपरेट ब्रिटिश बट हियर ही आस्क्ड इंडियंस डिसओबे द ब्रिटिश रूल एंड ही स्टार्टेड दिस मूवमेंट एज सॉल्ट मार्च और डांडी मार्च इसे सॉल्ट मार्च भी कहते हैं डांडी मार्च भी कहते हैं फ्रॉम साबरमती आश्रम टू डांडी कोस्ट विद 78 वॉलंटियर्स सरोजनी नायडू was one of the women member, Sarojini Naidu was one of the women member who joined this march from the very beginning. Sarojini Naidu, she was one of the women member, she joined this march from the very beginning. Gandhiji started from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi Coast and distance was 240 miles. Kitna distance tha? 240 miles. Distance from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi Coast was 240 miles. Delhi Gandhiji walked 10 miles. 10 miles chalte roj and wherever 10 miles completed, he took rest. Delhi he walked 10 miles. And when 10 miles completed, he stopped and took rest and there he delivered speeches. Women with their kids came out of their houses to listen to the speeches of Mahatma Gandhi and women were so impressed that they joined Mahatma Gandhi with their small kids. Women walked with Mahatma Gandhi in this march. Number of members, which was earlier only 78, now reached to 2 lakh. And on 6th April, आप इसे जब काउंट करोगे ना 240 miles daily walk 10 miles and mass started on 12th March 1930, तो आप जब ये सारा कैलकुलेट करोगे ना अपने आप डेट आ जाएगी 6th April, he reached Dandi on 6th April 1930, Gandhi ji reached Dandi coast on 6th April 1930. And here he broke down the salt law by boiling some sea water and by collecting some salt from the sea. So this is about civil disobedience movement. After seeing when Gandhiji broke down the laws, people in different parts of the country started breaking British laws. People refused to pay chowkidari taxes and they refused to pay revenue. Forest dwellers started collecting forest produce. And in plantation area, people started moving freely. So in different parts of India, people started breaking down the laws made by the British. After seeing Gandhiji, people started breaking down the laws made by British because in this moment, Gandhiji asked Indians to break down the laws made by the British. In Peshawar, Abdul Ghaffar Khan also broke down the laws made by British. Abdul Ghaffar Khan in Peshawar also broke down the laws made by the British. Abdul Ghaffar Khan in Peshawar also broke down the laws made by the British. He is popularly known as Frontier Gandhi. One more question. A Abdul Ghaffar Khan is popularly known as Frontier Gandhi, and he broke down the laws made by the British in Peshawar. He was arrested by the British and sent behind bars. Pandit Nehru was also arrested. British started arresting Indian people, and near about 1 lakh Indians were arrested and sent behind bars by the British. Gandhiji was shocked to see so many Indians as prisoners. He wanted to release these political prisoners, and that's why he asked Lord Irwin to release them, to release these political prisoners. So due to this, Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed. Which pact? Gandhi-Irwin Pact. Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed between Mahatma Gandhi and Lord Irwin on 5th March 1931. Gandhi-Irwin Pact. So, between Mahatma Gandhi and Lord Irwin. Irwin was the then Governor General of India. So between Mahatma Gandhi and Lord Irwin, Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed. And it was signed on 5th March 1930. You have to learn this date and year for one more question. When Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed on 5th March 1930, Gandhiji asked Lord Irwin to release the political prisoners. Near about 1 lakh people were in jail, and Gandhiji asked Lord Irwin to release these prisoners. So that's why Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed between Mahatma Gandhi and Lord Irwin on 5th March 1931. It had following provisions. 3 mark ka question aaya tha, hota hai right note on Gandhi-Irwin Pact. When it was signed, 1 mark to isi ka hi hota hai. Iski provisions likhoge to ye 3 marks ka ban jayega. It had following provisions. Ab kya provisions thi? Gandhiji asked Irwin to release the political prisoners. Gandhiji ki to ek hi shart thi, to release the political prisoners. Jo log civil disobedience movement ke time arrest hue the, unhe release karwana tha. Gandhiji asked Lord Irwin to release the political prisoners. And Irwin asked Gandhiji, ab Irwin ki do shartte thi. Irwin asked Gandhiji to call back civil disobedience movement. उसने कहा अपनी मूवमेंट वापस लो. एंड ही आल्सो आस्क्ड महात्मा गांधी टू अटेंड द सेकंड राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस दैट वुड बी हेल्ड इन लंदन. बिकॉज फर्स्ट राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस का आपको पता है ना, कांग्रेस ने बाइकॉट किया था. लाहौर सेशन में डिसीजन लिया था दैट दे वुड बाइकॉट द फर्स्ट राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस. बट हियर इरविन पोस्ट गांधी जी टू अटेंड द सेकंड राउंड टेबल कॉन्फ्रेंस दैट वुड बी हेल्ड इन लंदन. इरविन की दो शर्तें थी, कॉल बैक सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट and to attend the second round table conference that would be held in London. So these were the provisions. Gandhiji asked Irwin to release the political prisoners. Irwin asked Mahatma Gandhi to attend the second round table conference that would be held in London and to call back civil disobedience movement. Up. Gandhiji called back his movement. Gandhiji had withdrawn the movement and went to London to attend the second round table conference. Gandhiji ne apni movement wapas li, went to London to attend the second round table conference. In 1932, went to London to attend the second round table conference. But he was shocked because Irwin refused to release the political prisoners. Ab Gandhiji ne Irwin ki dono shartein puri ki. He called back his movement and went to London to attend the second round table conference. But Irwin refused. Gandhi ji ke to ek hi shart thi. Irwin refused to release the political prisoners. Gandhi ji got disappointed, came back to India and decided to relaunch civil disobedience movement. Dubara decision liya ki isko relaunch karte hain. Decided to relaunch civil disobedience movement. But this time people lost their faith in this movement and they didn't join this. And in 1934, this movement was totally failed. 1934 mein ye movement totally fail ho chuki thi. Gandhi ji came back from London. He decided to relaunch this movement. But this time people lost their faith and they didn't join this movement. This movement was totally failed in 1934. Puri tarah se fail ho gayi thi ye movement in 1934. So this is about civil disobedience movement. Write note on civil disobedience movement. Write note on Gandhi Irwin Pact. Kuch bhi aa jaye. Who is popularly known as Frontier Gandhi? है ना, कौन सी डेट को गांधी इरविन पैक्ट साइन हुआ? 12th, आपको याद रखना चाहिए 5th मार्च. सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट की डेट याद रखनी है 12th मार्च. एंड डांडी कब पहुंचे? 6 अप्रैल 1930. सो 1 मार्क क्वेश्चन, 3 मार्क क्वेश्चन, 5 मार्क क्वेश्चन. इज इट क्लियर? नेक्स्ट, अब सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट के बाद व्हेन गांधी जी केम बैक इंडिया ही वाज शॉक्ड. Still, Pandit Nehru, Abdul Ghaffar Khan was in jail and he decided to relaunch this movement, but this movement was totally failed in 1934. People didn't join this movement again. Ab, iske baad ab aa sakta hai, how people participated civil disobedience movement? Logon ne is movement mein kaise part liya? Yahan pe main ek point batati hu, but we will discuss it later. Second round table conference mein na, B.R. Ambedkar bhi the. So there were clashes between Mahatma Gandhi and B.R. Ambedkar in the second round table conference, but you will not write here. Sirf sun lo ke wahan pe inme clashes hue the second round table conference mein Mahatma Gandhi and B.R. Ambedkar mein. B.R. Ambedkar ne manga tha separate electorate for the Dalits and Gandhi ji declared past unto death. Unhone anchal tyag diya tha. To wahan pe Irwin jo tha na, he was on the side of B.R. Ambedkar because he wanted division of the people, Indian people. So Irwin, he was on the side of Lord Irwin. Sorry, Irwin was on the side of B.R. Ambedkar. Is it clear? Clashes hue B.R. Ambedkar and Mahatma Gandhi mein, kisko leke? Separate electorate. Gandhi ji was not in the favor of separate electorate because he was on the view this would lead to the division of the country. But Irwin was on the side of B.R. Ambedkar. Ye hum baad mein padhenge. Maine waise hi bataya. Now come to here. How people participated civil disobedience movement? लोगों ने इस मूवमेंट को कैसे ज्वाइन किया? ये पेपर में ऐसे ही क्वेश्चन आता होता है, इतना बड़ा क्वेश्चन नहीं देते. How people participated आपको ऐसे देंगे, how peasants participated this movement, how industrialists participated this movement. This movement की जगह civil dis. तो how women participated civil disobedience movement? Listen carefully. How high caste and low caste Hindus participated this movement. How Muslims participated this movement. ये सारे करने के बाद ये चैप्टर सिर्फ एक टॉपिक बचेगा, sense of collective belonging, and chapter complete हो जाएगा. First, how people participated civil disobedience movement. I have written first peasants. First heading आप बनाओगे peasants, and peasants को हम two parts में divide करके करेंगे. It will become easy to learn. अगर इकट्ठा करेंगे तो ये learn नहीं होगा. आप ऐसे ही लिख सकते हो और ऐसे ही आप पेपर में भी अटेम्प्ट कर सकते हो. इट विल बिकम इजी फॉर यू और गलत भी नहीं होएगा. ठीक है, फर्स्ट आप लिखोगे पीजेंट्स, फिर आप ए पार्ट ए में लिखोगे रिच पीजेंट्स एज आई हैव रिटन पीजेंट्स, देन ए रिच पीजेंट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू रिच पीजेंट्स. पहले हम रिच पीजेंट्स के बारे में करेंगे. ठीक है, अब यहाँ पे आप बताओगे पतिदार्स ऑफ गुजरात. यू हैव टू राइट बिकॉज ये पेपर में 1 मार्क में भी आते होते हैं. पतिदार्स ऑफ गुजरात एंड जाट्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश. जाट्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, नोट डाउन. पतिदार्स ऑफ गुजरात एंड जाट्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश were the active participants of this movement. ये rich peasants थे. पतिदार्स of Gujarat and Jats of Uttar Pradesh were the active participants of this movement. Civil disobedience movement was launched during the years of depression. You know it very well. You have read in 9th class years of depression in Germany chapter. You have read about years of depression in the whole world. Years of 1929 to 1932 were known as years of depression. पता है ना 1929 से लेके 1932 के इयर्स जो थे वो कौन से ईयर थे पूरे वर्ल्ड में? ईयर्स ऑफ डिप्रेशन. तो इंडिया में तो वैसे ही पुअर कंडीशन थी बिकॉज इंडिया वॉज द कॉलोनी ऑफ द ब्रिटिश. तो इसमें हम बताएंगे नॉर्थ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पतिदास ऑफ गुजरात एंड गार्ड्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश वर द एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ दिस मूवमेंट. इस मूवमेंट के एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेंट्स थे. सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट वॉज लॉन्च्ड ड्यूरिंग द ईयर्स ऑफ डिप्रेशन. क्योंकि ये 30 में लॉन्च हुई ना, तो 30 में तो डिप्रेशन के ईयर्स चल रहे थे. सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट वॉज लॉन्च्ड ड्यूरिंग द ईयर्स ऑफ डिप्रेशन इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस. ड्यूरिंग द ईयर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस जैसे अभी कोरोना पीरियड में चल रहे हैं, फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स हैं लोगों को. सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट वॉज लॉन्च ड्यूरिंग द ईयर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डिप्रेशन या इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस. रिच पीजेंट्स वर नॉट इन कंडीशन टू पे रेवेन्यू टू द गवर्नमेंट. रिच पीजेंट्स गवर्नमेंट को क्या नहीं दे पा रहे थे? रेवेन्यू. क्योंकि डिप्रेशन के ईयर्स चल रहे थे. अभी भी तो कोरोना पीरियड में सबको प्रॉब्लम्स आई हैं, फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स. तो रिच पीजेंट्स वर नॉट इन कंडीशन टू पे रेवेन्यू टू द गवर्नमेंट. एज यू नो ब्रिटिश नेवर रिमिटेड रेवेन्यू. आई टोल्ड यू बिफोर ब्रिटिश कभी भी रेवेन्यू रिमिट नहीं करते होते थे. पोस्टपोन कर देते थे बट रिमिट नहीं करते थे. तो रिच पीजेंट्स वॉन्टेड टू रिमिट देअर रेवेन्यू. वो रेवेन्यू रिमिट करवाना चाहते थे, अपना माफ करवाना चाहते थे. That's why they joined the civil disobedience movement, because they were on the view. Civil disobedience movement was launched during the years of depression. Rich peasants were not in condition to pay revenue to the government, and they wanted to remit the revenue. They joined civil disobedience movement because they were on the view that Gandhi ji would help them to remit their revenue from the British. उन्होंने इस मूवमेंट को इसलिए ज्वाइन किया था कि गांधी जी उनका रेवेन्यू ब्रिटिश से रिमिट करवा देंगे. They joined this movement because they were on the view that Gandhi ji would help them to remit their revenue from the British. But when Gandhi ji went to London to attend the second round table conference, after calling back this movement, but when Gandhiji went to London to attend the second round table conference after calling back this movement, he did nothing for these people. He did nothing for these people and did not consult with them. And when Gandhiji relaunched this movement, these people lost their faith. These people lost their faith and they didn't join the movement second time. These people lost their faith and they didn't join this movement second time. Is it clear, rich peasants? अभी मैंने सिर्फ rich peasants करवाया है. Next, poor peasants. ये 5 mark का क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. First of all, you will write about rich peasants, then about poor peasants. So ये peasants का collectively आप ऐसे आंसर बना दोगे. Poor peasants. अब इसमें आप बताओगे. Poor peasants had their fight with rich peasants. Poor का झगड़ा किसके साथ था? रिच पीजेंट्स के साथ, नॉट विद ब्रिटिश. पुअर पीजेंट्स हैड देयर फाइट विद रिच पीजेंट्स, नॉट विद ब्रिटिश. इनकी तो ब्रिटिश के साथ थी क्योंकि ये रेवेन्यू किससे माफ करवाना चाहते थे? ब्रिटिश से. पुअर पीजेंट्स हैड देयर फाइट विद रिच पीजेंट्स, नॉट विद ब्रिटिश. दे वॉन्टेड टू रिमिट देयर लैंड रेंट्स. रेंट्स वो रेवेन्यू रिमिट करवाना चाहते थे, ये रेंट. क्योंकि इन्होंने रिच पीजेंट से लैंड रेंट पे ली हुई थी. दे वांटेड टू रिमिट देयर लैंड रेंट्स. लैंड रेंट पे कौन देते थे? रिच पीजेंट्स. एंड पुअर पीजेंट्स वांटेड टू रिमिट देयर लैंड रेंट्स फ्रॉम द रिच पीजेंट्स. ये रिच पीजेंट से लैंड रेंट माफ करवाना चाहते थे. poor people had their fight with rich peasants, not with British. They wanted to remit their land rents from the rich peasants. That's why they joined this movement, but they were not given any support. They were not supported by the Congress. But they were not supported by the Congress. They were ignored because Congress had good relations with rich peasants and didn't want to spoil them. These people wanted to remit their land rents from the rich peasants. That's why they wanted to join this movement, but they didn't get support from the Congress. Congress ignored them because Congress had good relations with rich peasants and didn't want to spoil them. Congress ke rich peasants ke saath achhe relations the aur wo apne relations spoil nahi karna chahti thi. That's why poor peasants were ignored by Congress. क्योंकि पुअर की लड़ाई रिच के साथ थी एंड रिच वर द एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट एंड कांग्रेस डिडंट वांट टू स्पॉइल इट्स रिलेशंस विद रिच पीजेंट्स. दैट्स व्हाई पुअर पीजेंट्स वर इग्नोर्ड बाय द कांग्रेस. बस इतना याद रखना, ये रेवेन्यू नहीं दे पा रहे थे टू द ब्रिटिश, ये रेंट नहीं दे पा रहे थे टू रिच पीजेंट्स. इज इट क्लियर? पीजेंट्स वाला मुझे लगता है लर्न हो जाना चाहिए, लिखना तो दूर की बात है, लर्न हो जाना चाहिए. नेक्स्ट, इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट. इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट इसको भी हम ऐसे ही करेंगे, इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट देन वर्कर्स. ए पार्ट में हम करेंगे इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, बी में हम करेंगे वर्कर्स. पेपर में इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट आए, आपने वर्कर्स साथ में अपने आप लिखना है. रोल ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट आए, वर्कर्स साथ में ही लिखना है आपने, ठीक है? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू विल राइट इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट. अब इसमें आप बताओगे Industrialists were the active participants of this movement, and they were financial supporters also. Industrialists were the active participants of this movement, and they were the financial supporters of this movement. Financial supporters be the industrialists. Is it clear? Industrialists were the active participants of this movement, and they were the financial supporters of this movement. Financial supporters be the who? During First World War, अब उधर तो था कि years of depression थे, अब यहाँ पे क्या था? During the First World War, British imposed various restrictions on trade activities. During the First World War, British imposed various restrictions on the trade activities. Trade activities पे ban लगे हुए थे. These people wanted to get freedom of trade. ये लोग फ्रीडम ऑफ ट्रेड चाहते थे. ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर ब्रिटिश इंपोज वेरियस रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन ट्रेड एक्टिविटी. दीज पीपल वांटेड फ्रीडम ऑफ ट्रेड एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे ज्वाइंड द सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट, बिकॉज दे वर ऑन द व्यू दैट गांधी जी वुड हेल्प देम टू टेक फ्रीडम ऑफ ट्रेड. इनको था कि इस मूवमेंट को ज्वाइन करेंगे, गांधी जी हमें फ्रीडम ऑफ ट्रेड ब्रिटिश से लेके दे देंगे. That Gandhiji would help them to take freedom of trade from the British. Purushottam Das, Thakur Das, and G.D. Birla. You can see spelling from the book, students, please. Purushottam Das, Thakur Das, and G.D. Birla were the prominent industrialists in this movement. Purushottam Das, Thakur Das, and G.D. Birla were the prominent industrialists in this movement. Learn the name Purushottam Das, Thakur Das, and G.D. Birla were the prominent industrialists in this movement. Industrialists set up. अब ये 1 mark के लिए आप learn करोगे. IICC in 1920. Now write down its full form. Industrialists set up IICC. In 1920, write down the full form. Paper में full form पूछते होते हैं. Indian Industrial Commercial Congress. Indian Industrial Commercial Congress in 1920, and then FICCI in 1927, Industrialist setup IICC in 1920, Indian Industrial Commercial Congress. Then FICCI in 1927 and its full form, Federation of Indian Chamber and Commerce Industries. Is it clear? IICC, Indian Industrial Commercial Congress. FICCI, Federation of Indian Chamber and Commerce Industry in 1927. Is it clear? Industrialists set up these associations. But when Gandhiji, same as in Peasants of Britain, went to London after calling back this movement, he didn't consult with these people, did nothing for them. And when, after coming back from London, when Gandhiji relaunched this movement, these people lost their faith and they didn't join, same as you have written in Peasants. But when Gandhiji went to London after calling back this movement, he did nothing for these people. He didn't consult with them. And फिर आप बता दोगे consult भी नहीं किया. And after, when Gandhiji came back, he relaunched this movement. When he relaunched this movement, these people lost their faith. Industrialists lost their faith and they didn't join this movement. उन्होंने इस movement को join ही नहीं किया. इसी में आप करोगे workers. Workers. आज इतना ही होएगा, है ना, वर्कर्स कर लो, चलो बाकी हम कल करेंगे. वर्कर्स, तो इसमें आप बताओगे वर्कर्स हैड देयर फाइट विद इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट एज पुअर पीजेंट्स हैड देयर फाइट विद रिच पीजेंट्स. वर्कर्स हैड देयर फाइट विद इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, नॉट विद ब्रिटिश. वर्कर्स का ब्रिटिश के साथ झगड़ा ही नहीं था. दे हैड देयर फाइट विद इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट. दे वॉन्टेड टू इंक्रीज देयर वेजेस एंड टू रिड्यूस देयर वर्किंग आवर्स. They wanted to increase their wages and to reduce their working hours. But they were ignored by the Congress because Congress had good relations with industrialists and didn't want to spoil. Only in Nagpur region, workers joined this movement. सिर्फ नागपुर रीजन के वर्कर्स ने इस मूवमेंट को ज्वाइन किया था. दे वर सो इम्प्रेस्ड बाय महात्मा गांधी दैट दे स्टार्टेड बियरिंग गांधीयन कैप. दीज हियर वर्कर्स वर सो इम्प्रेस्ड बाय महात्मा गांधी दैट दे स्टार्टेड बियरिंग गांधीयन कैप. दे प्रोटेस्टेड, डिक्लेयर्ड स्ट्राइक्स, बट दे वर नॉट गिवन सपोर्ट बाय द कांग्रेस. ठीक है, अब आपको आगे आएगा इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट एंड वर्कर्स. वर्कर्स ने कहां पे ज्वाइन की है मूवमेंट? ओनली इन नागपुर रीजन. वर्कर्स ज्वाइंड दिस मूवमेंट. वर्कर्स इन नागपुर रीजन वर सो इंप्रेस्ड बाय महात्मा गांधी एंड दे स्टार्टेड वेयरिंग गांधीयन